ओके, दैट बी प्रेजेंटेशन। थैंक यू जी। So, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, this is lecture number 2. The course we started last week on blockchain technology and application. So again, showing you the sources of the content that I have put in my presentation is material from the internet, research publications, my personal perspective on some of the topics and care projects. Today I intend to cover 3 topics. One is role of money in society and cryptocurrency. We really need to understand the role of money, because the first application of blockchain is cryptocurrency, and that will help us to understand cryptocurrency. Otherwise it's very confusing that why something which is just a series of number has some value, and such a great value. So once we understand what money is, that will make us understand why cryptocurrency is real. And then we'll do a introduction or system level overview of blockchain, and that should lead us to study a technical subject which is very core to blockchain, and it is cryptographic hash function. So this is very core. So I'll try to cover these 3 topics. Hopefully we'll do a 50 minutes for topic 1, then take 10 minutes break, and then another 50 minutes for blockchain, then we take 20 minutes break, and then we do the third for 50 minutes. So just to recap what we discussed last time, it was about that how you make a transaction in a bank, and then that thing leading to e-cash. And I talked about David Chum and e-cash, where if Alice wants to get an e-cash or a digital coin, Chum suggested a method where Alice can blind the serial number so that bank should not find out the serial number. So people want privacy once they are doing transaction. They don't want the bank to know to who they are giving their money. So he suggested that blinding the serial number and sending it to the bank, and bank then would issue with a signature, validate that okay, for this money, this is the e-cash which you can spend, and then Alice unblind the serial number. Okay, so bank does not have the serial number. Bank has only affirmed a digital signature, making that number a valid number. So there is a number, then there is another number. So this number is the bank signature, and this number is the serial number. And now Alice can give that to Bob with the actual serial number. Okay. And then he can get whatever he wants, and then Bob can give that serial number to the bank, and bank would just record that serial number, that this serial number, and bank has no way of knowing that this serial number is coming from Alice, because bank has so many customers, and bank has affirmed his signature of $1, $5, $10, $100, depending upon the note. And then is but then it brings the most critical problem of digital currency, that is the double spend problem. That if it is only a serial number, the Alice can give it to somebody else as well, because he can just give it, because it's just transferring a number and 2 numbers, and Charlie has no way of knowing that this is a double spend money. This money has already been spent. And so blockchain primarily solve this double spend problem, okay, where a digital number cannot be spent twice. And we will see that how this is achieved, a double spend problem, how it can be solved once it is a digital currency, okay. And it's not about just money, it is about anything which has value, may it be land, may it be music, may it be a piece of art, okay, a digital art. So this is for anything which has value, how can you make sure that it is not spent twice, okay? If you don't want it to be spent twice. Sometimes you want things to be spent multiple times, like my lecture, and I would like the lecture to be copied as many times as possible. So I just make a copy of it and put it on the group, and you can just get a copy of it. So this is once you want, but for certain things you don't want people to make copies. So Bitcoin basically about a decentralized money, solving the double spend problem, okay. So then, as I mentioned, that we need to learn about the role of money, and that will make us understand the Bitcoin. And these are some readings which I would like you to do. It's an IEEE spectrum. There is an article about a brief history of money. And then the book which I shared on the group, and there is also a very elaborate treatment of money and history of money, and I would like you to read that. It's like a good story, right? So that will again help you to understand this better, that the history of money and the history of ledgers is then another reading which I want you to do. So once people talk about money, they say, if something has these three characteristics, you can call it money, okay? The first characteristic is that a medium of exchange. So if something which can you can use to get something else, okay? A medium of exchange is that it's easy and efficient way for you to trade goods and services with one another. So this is the property number one. So we will gauge if Bitcoin has these three properties or not. In the history of money, if anything was considered as money, had these three qualities or not. So one is the medium of exchange. We know that if you have money, you can just go and buy anything. So this is medium of exchange. Second is store of value. Like if something is, for example, a crop, you cannot just store it for many, many months and years. But if there is something which you can store, okay, this is also money, that it has a value and you can store it to be used later. So a store of value, meaning that money allows you to defer consumption until a later date. So you have it and you don't want to spend it, right? So this is the second characteristic of money, that you can just keep it to yourself, and later, whenever you want to consume, you can consume it. So the third property is that unit of account, that it is a way to measure your wealth. Okay, so even a plot, you always assign a number. So it's a unit of account. Okay, it is for these many crore rupees or, you know. So it should be a unit of account, that something that you can value things in this unit, as you value height in meters. So you value certain thing, taking money as a unit of account. Okay, so three things, just remember, medium of exchange, store value, unit of account. So we will come back and see that whether these characteristics are fulfilled by the other form of money or not, okay? So unit of account is something that you can use to compare the value of two items also, that this is expensive, this is less expensive, or to count up the total value of your assets. You say he is a billionaire or a millionaire, or, you know, so that means it's also a unit of account. So there is something which is called a duck test. So in order for us to say that something is money or not, we apply the simple test, okay? So it says that if it looks like a duck, swims like a duck, and quack like a duck, then it is probably a duck. So if those three characteristics are there, and we say, yes, it is money. So So this is the article which I was talking about. It says a brief history of money, and perhaps the very first line in this article says that money has been mum about its origin. So it would not obviously tell that how it, like, money started in a society. So there are two thinkings on that how money started. One is that mainstream economists assume that money started with bartering, where you barter. You say, I have a hen and you have a goat, so perhaps we can barter for so many hens to a goat. So people would just barter. Somebody has one valuable thing, the other has another valuable thing, and they could just barter. And then if, let's say, I don't need hens, okay, and I need a coat or cloth, and these two parties does not have that, so then we need to find a third person.
Bartering is
like you have a mobile phone, I have a laptop, and you need a laptop, I need a mobile phone. You say, I'll give you my mobile and you give me your laptop, so this is bartering. But what if this is called coincidence of want is not there. Like, for example, I have hens and you have a goat, but I need cloth. So we need to find a person, okay, who wants to trade clothes for either hen or for this, so that we can bring another third party, so that we have some common coincidence of want. And if even does not have, we need to find a fourth person. So the network starts growing, because we got to have people who have similar wants, otherwise this will not happen. Perhaps this made people to have something which is common. They say, okay, this is something common, so I trade this with this common thing, which is money, for example, and you also trade this, so they bring something which is common, and so that anybody can trade. So this is one thinking, that this is how money started. And the other is by anthropologists and archaeologists, and they don't trust and they don't believe that money has started like this. They said it is primarily government or whosoever is ruling, he wants to tax people, okay, and people want to get a loan, so that's how money has started. So money has started because people are got to be paid, or government has to, or whosoever is ruling has to collect taxes, and you cannot collect tax by having somebody's hen or a goat, because you cannot store it. And so money has started because of this need of people to pay people to get loan, and this is how the money has started. So this is, for example, this article talks about this, that around 600 years ago, Aztec rulers may have acquired large amount of cocoa and cotton cloth, and they would accept these items as tax. Okay? So all these items were considered as money because they accepted. So they take this as taxing people, and they can award somebody the same. Okay? So these are the things which were valuable. Similarly, this shows some 1400 years, a marketplace where bartering is happening. Like, people are bringing something and they can barter it for something else. So this is also a nice idea, that you have a marketplace where people can bring whatever they have, and they can find other people who have other things, and then you can just barter. The book talks about, which I shared with you, talks about four types of money. One is money barter. Okay. So barter, which is let's exchange valuable things. The second is commodity money. The money is the valuable things, and we'll cover this. The third is representative money, and fourth is fiat currency, which is we use today. So So barter, as I mentioned earlier, it is double coincidence of wants. Like both parties needs to have mutual wants, that I need this, I need this, so we are the two people, so we can exchange. So that is basically initiated money, which is something common, and we can just trade our things using this common thing of value. And so I can just go and basically trade anything if I have money in my pocket. So as this is again an article I was reading, and this guy from Cambridge, he believes that there has never been such a thing where the money started with the bartering. And he strongly believes that it is because of people got to pay taxes, or because of another thing which I'll be discussing in a while. So this is interesting. This is the commodity money. So commodities that clearly have an intrinsic value, like cattle, has been used as money. A cattle, which is basically has a value, because you say it can be used to trade, and so you can get something which you want. It is also unit of account, so you can count how many cattle you have, and it has a store value, because cattle though is valuable because it grows. It one cattle you can have 2 and 3 and 4. So cattle has been used as money, and because it kind of satisfies all the three conditions which we said that these three conditions should be met, so we can call something as money. So people started using objects where they were scarce, and they got to be durable. And and like today, we argue about Bitcoin. At that time, people must be arguing about that, why the cattle is fine and goat is fine, but how about a stone? How can stone be valuable, or a bronze be valuable, or a silver be valuable to use as a money? But so this is very interesting. This is primarily a stone where people would, this is Yap Island, they would sail 400 kilometers to another island to quarry limestone from caves and rock shelters. So they will bring this, and it has as tall as a man. It's very heavy. So they were using this as money, something very valuable. So they were using this, and I was reading that once they were just bringing it, so the boat sank, and they kept using it, though something was under the sea, and they kept using it for many, many years, that thing which is under the sea has some value, and it is owned by my father, so you can inherit it to your son, and they kept using it. So this has been used as money, and people would place it in front of their houses, and to show that how rich they are. And then similarly, this cup-shaped beads have been used as money some 800 years ago. So comes the time once people start using non-metal money, like salt bars, the scory shells, telly stakes, rice stones we just discussed. So these were used as money, something which is not very common. And obviously they cannot eat it, but because they believe it is valuable, and they started using this as money. Okay. Then they started using the metal money, bronze and copper plates in Sweden, and bronze in China and Rome. And so they started using the metal, a piece, lump of metal as money. Okay. And so then started the coins. So they started minting coins. Okay. And they'll put shapes of kings and others on coins. So these are, like, they started minting money. They will mint it. And in China, you know why there is a hole in this Chinese yuan? Any guesses? So they have this hole. So if you look at Chinese yuan, so they can basically put it in a string, and the string will measure that how many coins are there. So 100 strings is a 100 coin string. So you just keep putting without counting, and once you reach at the end, it means there are 100 coins. So to count these automatically, they put a hole in the coin, and then there were strings, which is 10 coin string and 100 coin string, and you see this guy holding 100 coin string. So then came the representative money. So it was not metal or non-metal. What would happen that people would have, let's say I have my rice and I put it in a store, and the person who owns the store would give me a promising note that I have this valuable stored here. And people started using that promising note as money, that look, I have this worth of cotton or whatever in the store. So they started trading the promising note as money. Okay. So those then stores and goldsmiths, this is how the bank started, like those people, because they were issuing promising notes, okay, and most of them were just private people, and those promising notes were considered as notes or as bills that we use today, and people would trade that because they know that if I'm giving it to somebody, he can go and collect that valuable thing which is stored in the store. So they started using promising note as money. So there were so many then, so to say, banks issuing promising notes and giving loans. It's charging.
इसने पूछा माउस इशू कर रहा
है नहीं इसने कहा कि नहीं है बैटरी नहीं लो बैटरी का आया था व्हाट वाज ओके ठीक है हाँ वो मुझे बता दे ठीक है सो दैट्स हाउ द बैंक्स इवॉल्व फ्रॉम वेयर हाउसेस दैट वर places for safe keeping of commodities such as grain, cattle and precious metals. So people would store their gold, they get a promising note. It is easier to carry a promising note than a gold or a copper or even cattle or grain. So people started trading with the promising notes. And then the government thought need of a central bank, because promising notes coming from so many different banks and were creating all kind of problems. People may or may not accept it, because let's say if you travel, you go to another city and you present that promising note, and that guy may or may not accept it because he has to travel back to another place to get the value from that promising note. Promising because it's a promise that if you bring this back, so he will return whatever you have in that warehouse. So it's called, that's why it is called a promising note. ठीक है? और उस पे लिखा भी यही होता है कि yeah, yes, yes. We'll talk about this in a while. अभी हम उस पे. So then it was in 1844. Once in UK, they said no bank can print its own promissory note, it will be only the Bank of England. So came the state bank, like we have a State Bank of Pakistan, and so every country has a state bank. So they said it can only a state bank can issue a promissory note. Okay. So then we also need to understand, like people thought that whether it is a promissory note or a currency, it has to be linked with something which is valuable. This is very important to understand. Has to be linked with something valuable. So they made a United Kingdom made a gold standard, that you got to have a reserve of gold, okay, and you can only issue these many notes. So they has to be backed up by real gold. Okay? So, in the 1970s, gold standard was adopted by Germany, France, and United States, and with many other countries following suit. So, you got to have a reserve of gold, and only then you can issue. जी वो आपकी वैल्यू है, दिस इज द वैल्यू ऑफ योर करेंसी. ओके, सो वैल्यू ऑफ योर करेंसी विल बी डिटरमिन्ड दैट हाउ मच गोल्ड यू हैव, बिकॉज अमाउंट ऑफ गोल्ड एंड द करेंसी यू हैव इन द मार्केट शुड इक्वेट इटसेल्फ. ओके, सो दैट इज हाउ दे वुड एक्चुअली एबल टू ट्रेड अ डॉलर वर्सेज अ पाउंड वर्सेज दिस. बट देन वॉट हैपन, सो यू स्टिल गेट, सो यू
हैव
नहीं, दिस इज नॉट अ फिएट मनी, दिस इज अ मनी विच इज ऑन द गोल्ड स्टैंडर्ड, दिस इज नॉट फिएट मनी. ठीक है, विल कम टू द फिएट मनी इन अ वाइल. सो दिस ऑल्सो स्टार्टेड फ्रैक्शनल रिजर्व बैंकिंग, लाइक यू हैव अ गोल्ड इन द बैंक. ओके, एंड बैंक द सेंट्रल बैंक सेड दैट यू कैन ओनली हैव टू कीप 10% इन रिजर्व. If I deposit some gold, they give me some dollars, and out of that gold, let's say if it is, it has like 10 pieces of gold, so I only have to keep one in the bank, and 9 then I can loan it to somebody. Okay, so 9 I loan it to somebody, and that somebody again brings that 9 and deposit it in the bank, and out of 9 again I keep only. I only have to keep 10%. So this is called fractional reserve banking, where you are using the same value multiple times because you only have to keep 10% in the bank. 90% you can loan it to people. So we'll come back to the fractional reserve banking. ठीक है? And then there were many. यार ये क्या मसला है? Shows it is charging, but kya kare. Charge to kar raha hai, lekin hai charge nahi ho raha. इसी में होता है, हो रहा है, अब हो रहा है ना, अब हो रहा है ना, इट इज चार्ज. ओके ठीक है, इसको मैं या ओके. सो देवर टाइम्स व्हेन इवन यूके वुड नॉट लिंक इट्स करेंसी विद द गोल्ड स्टैंडर्ड, एंड देन इट हैज़ टू कम बैक बिकॉज अदरवाइज करेंसी विल नॉट बी ऑनर्ड, विल नॉट बी वैल्यूड. So they have to come, keep coming back and linking their currency with the gold standard. So, but then what happens? World War I happened, World War II happened, and almost all the gold reserves, America had all the gold reserves of the world. Most of the gold reserves were with America because America was not in the war in that way. People were buying things from America, and so Americans started getting gold. So they had big pile of gold, and so almost dollar was gold because America ke paas hi gold. So America has this gold, so dollar was equated to gold. So everybody has to have dollars, so had to have dollars in order to link in reserves, in order to link it, because dollars was equivalent to gold. So instead of, and they can always take those dollars to America and get gold out of it, because like this dollar was kind of a promissory note as well, that it was linked with dollars, with gold. So, and that's why the American dollar became very strong. It was kind, every country could have this as a reserve instead of gold, because every country knew that this actually is gold, because, and it actually happened once Americans were in Vietnam War and this war, and they had to spend, then people like France, the countries like France, they wanted the gold from the dollar. So they would take dollars and said, send us the gold. Okay. So it was then, in 1971, seeing that there were scarce of gold, Americans ke paas, they did not have that much gold. So then Nixon basically ended convertibility of US dollar to gold. He says no more, the US dollar will not be equated with gold anymore. Okay? So this happened in 1971. So then came your fiat money. And the fiat money is which is issued by the government but is not backed up by any commodity such as gold. Okay? It's just piece of paper. So fiat money is a piece of paper which whenever the government wants, the American government wants, it can print as many dollars as they want. Okay? So because you don't have to back it up with any commodity. Okay? So the fiat money gives central banks greater control over the economy because they can control how much money is to be printed. To print a $10 note, they only have to spend 3 cents. Okay? So this is the money they have to spend. 3 cents and you print a $10 note. So you make a lot of money by actually printing, because in printing you are only spending very little money, but you are getting a lot of value out of that. So most modern paper currencies, including US dollars, are fiat currency. So is Pakistani rupee, and so all these are fiat money. So obviously one danger of fiat money is that government will print too much of it, resulting in hyperinflation. Many countries, you must be knowing, ke wo, the currency is worth nothing because it's just a piece of paper. फिएट में डिफरेंस ये है, पहले जो होता था ना, डॉलर पे लिखा होता था कि यू कैन टेक दिस डॉलर एंड यू कैन गेट गोल्ड आउट ऑफ इट. ओके जी, गोल्ड, बिकॉज गोल्ड स्टैंडर्ड था. ठीक है, सो दे हैव एन इक्विवेलेंट रिजर्व ऑफ गोल्ड विच इज बैक्ड अप बाय द करेंसी. सो यू हैड दिस कॉन्फिडेंस दैट दिस डॉलर आई हैव इन माई हैंड इज एक्चुअली पीस ऑफ गोल्ड, इट इज नॉट पीस ऑफ पेपर. सही है, लाइक अ प्रॉमिसरी नोट. Where you have this note and you know it has value because there is something in the store, so you were comfortable. Okay, theek hai, mere paas ye hai, but it is, though it is a piece of paper, but it has a value. Now fiat currency, okay, this is just a piece of paper. So it is. Ab ye bada interesting hai. That basically makes you understand about the Bitcoin as well. Okay, so it is because you believe it is valuable. Because you know, if you go out and you want to buy something, a lunch, so somebody will accept it. So they say it is a social consensus that everybody believes it is valuable. That's why it is valuable. Otherwise, it has no value.
So this means that our currency is backed by gold instead.
Our money is not backed up by gold. No, nobody's money is backed up by gold anymore. Okay, nobody's money is backed up by gold anymore. It is just a piece of paper. ठीक है, ये this is again is very very important for us to understand. So what is money? It is just a belief.
So we see many videos on YouTube where Bank of England, and they reserve some currency and
no more. Nobody reserves gold and equate it to the money they are printing. They can just print as much money as they want. Okay, so it is this common belief that this what you have in your hand is a value. And why this belief? Because you know that if government wants you to pay taxes, government will accept this piece of paper. जी जी, devalue भी इसलिए हो रही है कि government keep printing. ठीक है, so keep printing notes, so it gets devalued. Because अगर ये जितना मर्जी print करें, इसी से inflation होती है. This is what they have to control. They got to be very cautious, because once they print, ठीक है, योर थिंग गेट्स डीवैल्यूड. जिस एक देर इज अ हाउसिंग सोसाइटी विच हैज 100 प्लॉट्स, इट इज वैल्यूएबल, एंड समबडी एड्स 900 मोर. ओके, एंड नोबडी वांट्स टू बाय दोस, सो द वैल्यू विल गो डाउन. ठीक है, बिकॉज दे प्रिंट मोर एंड मोर. बट ऑन द अदर हैंड, बिटकॉइंस आर वेरी कन्फाइंड. ओके, दे यू कैन ओनली प्रिंट, यू कैन ओनली क्रिएट दीज मैनी, विच इज नाउ 6.25 बिटकॉइन एवरी 10 minutes. So it is very confined, and after by 2040, so there will be no more bitcoins, new bitcoins. So you have to use this. So it gains value, loses based on speculation, but the money is just a belief. It's a societal consensus that in a society people start believing. It has always been like this. Jab wo beads the ya quarry stone tha, or so people believe that this piece of metal has some value, and they would just use it as money. So now the fiat currency is also like this.
Every currency is valued or devalued against dollar.
Yeah, because of the historical reasons.
So dollar have no value and devalue.
Nahin, dollar has a value and devalue. I'll show you in a while. Okay, dollar ki value or devalue kya hai? I'll show you. So who controls it? The central bank controls it. Okay. Yeah, you can basically trade that. You can have, like, they usually say that Bitcoin is not money, it is a digital asset. Okay, they say it's a digital asset, not money. उसके बाद अदर क्रिप्टोकरेंसीज, अगर आप देखें बेशुमार क्रिप्टोकरेंसीज हैं, बिटकॉइन विल ओनली यू विल ट्रेड दोज मैनी, बस उनकी वैल्यू बढ़ती जाएगी. जी ये जिस द पर्सन हु बेसिकली केम अप विद दिस आइडिया, सतोशी नाकामोटो. जी
ये तो डिसेंट्रलाइज्ड थिंग है ना, कोई
भी. या बट ही वांटेड दिस टू बी कंट्रोल्ड. ही डज नॉट वांट के जी एनीबॉडी कुड जस्ट क्रिएट इट. उसकी कोई अथॉरिटी, नो बडी हैज एनी अथॉरिटी ऑन दिस. ठीक है, मेरे ख्याल हमारे आई थिंक वी कैन टेक 5 मिनट्स ब्रेक. वो दूसरा लैपटॉप ले आना. जी पूछे. मेरा ख्याल है कि शायद हमने हटाना ना वो नहीं किया. अमेरिकन रिमूव्ड इट फ्रॉम द डॉलर नोट. अमेरिकन्स ने अपने डॉलर नोट पे लिखा होता था, दे रिमूव्ड इट. है नहीं, नहीं अभी नहीं लिखा हुआ. अमेरिकन अभी नहीं लिखा, पहले लिखा हुआ था. जी वो हम अभी देखते हैं कि बिटकॉइन किस तरह से इस चीज को वैल्यूएबल बनाता है. यार लैपटॉप देना. जी ऑन द इंटरनेट ही सेज मनी इज नॉट द वैल्यू for which goods are exchanged, but the value by which they are exchanged. So just a medium of exchange hai, by itself has no value. So this was his idea about money. And so this I talked to you about fractional reserve banking, where you only have to keep a bank only if you deposit, let's say, 1 crore rupees in the bank. The bank only needs to keep 10% of it, like 10 lakh, and then 90 lakh it will loan it to somebody. And if somebody again deposited in the bank again keeps only 10% and then again loan. So the same money is loaned so many times. Okay? And that generates an economic activity as well. But it is kind of a double spend, that you are just spending that money again and again and again. Okay? And so $100 will be $1,000 worth of money that will be in circulation. Okay? So $100 is worth $1,000 because of this reason. And even recently they have no requirement on reserves. So even the banks may not even keep any reserve. They can just, so you can just see that how this banks, they make money because they don't have to keep your money. They can just reinvesting it again and again and again and again. Circulation hoti ja rahi hai, okay? So people believe that there is a 1 quarter million is $1,000 trillion in circulation because of the way the banks operate. Theek hai. एंड दिस इज जो हम डिस्कस कर रहे थे इन 2008 वंस देयर वाज अ क्राइसिस, जो उनकी मॉर्गेज की वो थी सारी क्रैम्प हुई, देयर वर मेनी फाइनेंशियल इंस्टीट्यूशंस दे वर शट डाउन, सो दे इंजेक्टेड लॉट ऑफ डॉलर्स टू बाय आउट ऑल द प्रॉपर्टीज विच पीपल बेसिकली कुड नॉट पे देयर मनी एंड फंड्स. So, and this is how they generated. This is interesting. It is an interview of the chair of the Federal Reserve. They print by typing it into a computer. That's how they generate money. They say, okay, this much money has been generated. Okay, generated. Because you don't need to have, actually, you don't need to print money. You can just say this much money has been generated. A $700 billion has been generated. So, that's it. Okay. Yes. Yes. It's kind of a private company. Okay. So that's how they generate money. So that's this is how the dollar is going down. Okay, the dollar in 1930, and this is the dollar. Okay, so every currency goes down. That also tells you, and not only this is dollar worth is. It says here, purchasing power of US dollar, $100 in 1913 is only $3.87 today. Okay. And similarly, all the currencies, this is rest of the currencies, they all are going down. So whether it is Egypt, Morocco, Thailand, India, Pakistan, Turkey, Japan, Philippines, United Kingdom, so all currencies, they take the same trend. So that also tells you that you must not keep just currency, because it's just going to follow the same trend. So this is red is what Pakistan and the Turkey lira is also. Kaun sa sentence? Yeah. जी जी sorry sorry. आज का जो 3.87 हाँ सही है ना? हाँ नहीं 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 सही कह रहे हैं. जो उसकी वैल्यू जो $100 की वैल्यू जो है ना वो एक तरह से ठीक है. जो $100 की वैल्यू थी ना 1913 में जो 100 या थ्री उसकी वर्थ जो है वो $100 की वर्थ इस वक्त $3.87 है. $100 की वर्थ इस वक्त $3.87 है. आज का $100 जो है उस जमाने का $3.87 है. यू कैन से इट लाइक दिस. सही है. तो कह रहे हैं ठीक है, यानी कि आज जो जो आज का $100 है इट इज ओनली 3.87 ऑफ टुडे. जी ओके जी सही. और ये आप देखिए दिस इज वेयर दे समथिंग हैपेंस, वॉल स्ट्रीट क्रैश एंड सो समथिंग हैपेंड. So, जी जी वो ज़्यादा दैट वॉज मोर फोकस ऑन आई टी कंपनीज, बट देन देर वॉज फाइनेंशियल क्राइसिस एज वेल मैनी अ टाइम, जिसको ग्रेट डिप्रेशन ये कहते हैं ना. सो सो दीज आर द करेक्टरिस्टिक ऑफ मनी, वी कैन सीन ऑल ऑफ दिस. There is an other terminology which is used, and we need to know this. This is called a legal tender. A legal tender is by law, so this law of the state where people must accept it. Right? Law of the state says that people must accept. So a rupee is a legal tender in Pakistan, but it may not be a legal tender in India or Bangladesh, Pakistani rupee. But it may be a legal tender in Afghanistan, for example. Okay. So the legal tender is a money. So Bitcoin is not a legal tender. See? So it may be money, but it may not be a legal tender. So legal tender by law, people got to accept it as a mechanism to meet a financial obligation or the people to pay taxes. So this is called a legal tender. So, ji. अच्छा नहीं मैंने मैंने जितना पढ़ा है ना द पीपल गॉट टू एक्सेप्ट इट बाय लॉ बिकॉज अ लॉ दैट यू हैव टू एक्सेप्ट इट. फॉर एग्जांपल दिस इज अ सर्टेन नंबर ऑफ कॉइन्स, लेट्स से मोर देन 100 coins is not a legal tender. Like if you need to pay somebody in America, you cannot pay him in coins where the coins are more than 100. So it is not a legal tender. So people can say, I don't accept it. Okay? So it, GG. नहीं नहीं देखें उस आई डोंट नो कि किए थे कि नहीं किए थे बट इट इज़ अप टू द स्टेट बैंक वेदर टू प्रिंट मोर मनी और नॉट सी दे मस्ट बी कंसिडरिंग सो मेनी थिंग्स टू डिसाइड वेदर हाउ मच मनी दे आर गोइंग टू प्रिंट बट एंड ऑफ द डे उनका ये जो चीफ होता है फेडरल रिजर्व का ठीक है जो कि 4 years के लिए आता है बट देन दे आर पीपल हु हैव सर्व फॉर 20-30 years and he is the most powerful person in America. They say it is not the president of America but the guy who is chief of their federal reserve, he is the most powerful person in America because he decides ki usne kitne dollar print karne hain, kitna wo karna hai. Okay, so this brings us to Bitcoin. Okay, so Bitcoin, like we did last time, we studied that it all started with this paper from Satoshi Nakamoto, and nobody knows who this person is. So he started this, and this was his email. I have been working on a new electronic cash system that is fully peer-to-peer with no trusted third party. Okay. So it basically will take out a bank from the middle. And so bank has no control in generating when to decide that they are going to print more money. So bank has no control. Okay. So it is just peer-to-peer, and he defined everything that how many bitcoins, after how many it will be split into half. So this is how the Bitcoin is behaving. So it goes up and down, up and down. It's not behaving, it's just going down and down. Okay. So Bitcoin ki is waqt jo hai, it is $2 trillion worth of worth volume. Crypto ki volume jo hai, so $2 trillion hai. So it is becoming significant. So the cryptocurrency is becoming significant, and so it is becoming, because the global equity market is $80 trillion, global debt and bond market is $250 trillion, global holding of gold. So it used to be very little, $250 billion, nobody would notice. Now people have started taking notice of this because it is becoming significant as compared to others. So last time I read this.
I have a question here.
Gigi. जी एस अ गुड क्वेश्चन. देखिए सप्लाई डिमांड का क्या होता है कि वंस यू हैव मोर डिमांड देन सप्लाई, इसकी वैल्यू इंक्रीज करना शुरू कर देती है. सो दिस इज प्रिसाइजली व्हाट इज हैपनिंग विद द बिटकॉइन. इट्स वैल्यू इज इंक्रीजिंग फ्रॉम फ्यू डॉलर्स टू 47,000 or 46,000 dollars, एंड इट हैज़ ऑल्सो इन स्मॉलर यूनिट्स. 10^8 सतोशी इज इक्वल टू 1 bitcoin. ओके, सो यू कैन स्पेंड योर मनी इन स्मॉलर यूनिट्स विच इज सतोशी. एंड देन देयर आर लाइक कीपिंग इन परस्पेक्टिव दिस होल आइडिया, इवन इन पाकिस्तान वी कैन स्टार्ट आवर ओन क्रिप्टो करेंसी. ओके, सो सेम आइडिया, वी कैन स्टार्ट आवर ओन क्रिप्टो करेंसी. नो बडी इज स्टॉपिंग एनी बडी टू स्टार्ट अ क्रिप्टो करेंसी. लाइक इफ पीपल स्टार्ट बिलीविंग एंड एक्सेप्टिंग इट, सो दैट इज द रीजन देयर आर अदर क्रिप्टो करेंसीज एज वेल. सो यू डोंट हैव टू जस्ट ट्रेड इन बिटकॉइन, you can opt for other cryptocurrencies as well. So ye ji
question here, sir, agar like you say ki demand versus supply ka jo hi hota hai, ki for demand is more and supply is less, to when you see value pa jana
ji
exactly. Ab the thing is ki ek ज्यादा वॉलेटाइल नहीं होती, दे वुड लाइक टू इन्वेस्ट इन दैट
जी,
ताकि वो जो अनसीन टाइप ऑफ फ्लक्चुएशन है अवॉइड दैट. सेकंड थिंग इज कि अभी भी बिटकॉइन की जो से एक्सुबरेंस एग्जिस्ट, व्हाट इफ दिस एक्सुबरेंस विल वेयर आउट, ये नीचे आएगा तो बिल्कुल इस तरह से सिचुएशन हो जाएगी कि स्टॉक मार्केट बिल्कुल क्रैश कर देगी एंड सडनली द रियल्स आर पॉइंट आउट.
जी आप सही कह रही हैं, दैट्स द रीज़न पीपल डोंट काउंट बिटकॉइन एज अ मनी, दे काउंट इट एज अ डिजिटल एसेट, लाइक यू हैव प्लॉट्स, यू हैव अदर थिंग्स, सो इट इज़ एन एसेट नॉट अ करेंसी. सो दैट काइंड ऑफ यू कैन जस्ट कीप इट एज एन एसेट एंड इफ इट्स देर इज़ मोर डिमांड इट्स वैल्यू विल इंक्रीज एंड डेफिनेटली देर इज़ वॉलेटिलिटी इन दिस होल थिंग. और बहुत सारे लोग लाइक एलन मस्क, वंस ही स्टार्टेड यू नो ओनिंग क्रिप्टो करेंसी, तो इन सब की वैल्यू बहुत ऊपर चली गई थी. चाइना हैज स्टॉप पीपल टू माइन, सो नो, सो दीज आर द थिंग्स, इट इज़ हाईली स्पेक्यूलेटिव बट पीपल आर स्टिल इन्वेस्टिंग इन इट. सो इट हैज़ मोर टू डू विद द, एज आई सेड, सोशल कॉन्सेंसिस है ये ज़्यादा, ना कि अदरवाइज इट लुक्स क्रेजी दैट पीपल आर इन्वेस्टिंग इन दिस. ओके, बट बिकॉज ऑफ रीजन्स के लोग जो हैं उनका ट्रस्ट इस पर बढ़ता जा रहा है, दैट्स व्हाई दे आर इन्वेस्टिंग इन इट. जी जी प्लीज. यस It is a lot more than the faith. It is because it is not everybody. So in its generation, they have taken so many safeguards. And those safeguards are basically making people to trust on this. ठीक है, ये जो भी हम safeguards देखेंगे, और I'll give you an assignment also today. So because of those safeguards, people are trusting this. Because it is not being generated free of cost. Like as we mentioned ke $10 note ke liye you only have to spend 3 cents, but to generate bitcoins you have to spend lot of power to generate very few bitcoins. To ye faith bhi hai, lekin ye bas ek aisa phenomenon hai which is just happening and people are still trying to understand ki kis tarah se ye cheez ban rahi hai, chal rahi hai.
Bahut bada inhone money ki investment.
नहीं, परहैप्स नॉट, परहैप्स अगर इसको मार देते लोग, यू नो, इफ ही वुड हैव कम अप, बिकॉज ही इज थ्रेटनिंग ऑल द स्टेट बैंक्स इन द वर्ल्ड, ही इज थ्रेटनिंग द होल फाइनेंशियल सिस्टम ऑफ द वर्ल्ड. सही है, सो इट माइट बी बिकॉज ऑफ दैट. आई डोंट थिंक सो, इट इज नॉट, नहीं कुछ भी नहीं होता मेरे, आई डोंट थिंक सो देर इज अ माफिया, इट हैज़ जस्ट टेकन इट्स नेचुरल समथिंग जस्ट स्टार्ट गेटिंग इन. Okay, and now more and more people are getting into this, so I don't think so it's mafia or it is now something real. Theek hai, $2 trillion worth of market capitalization means it is something which is real, and but as I mentioned in my first class, my interest is not in Bitcoin or cryptocurrency, my interest is in other application of blockchain that we are going to study today, that what is a blockchain. Theek hai. So as its name says, a blockchain is a chain of blocks that you tie a number of blocks together through a chain. So now today we will see what is there in a block and what is this chain, how you create this chain to tie this block with another block. So this is what we need to investigate today. So it's also called a distributed ledger. A distributed ledger, that there is a distributed database, a shared table where everyone has a copy of the shared table. Okay, so from the Satoshi paper, and if you go through this, I have shared that paper, it's just 11 pages and you can read it, perhaps you will not understand it, there are many technicalities which we will cover in this course, but one thing you will see is the hash, that there is a hash. Then you will see a block. In his paper, there is a block. then you will see item, item, item. So a block has different items. Basically, these are the transactions. That all the transactions in 10 minutes are clumped together in a block, and they are hashed. So these are hashed along with the hash of the previous block. A hash of the previous block. So this is what the chain is. The chain is that once you are hashing, and today we will cover this hashing in detail, then once you are creating a hash, you also include hash of the previous block. So that if नहीं हैश एड्रेस नहीं होता, आज हम उसको डिटेल में देखेंगे, ठीक है. हैश इज नॉट एन एड्रेस, इट्स अ क्रिप्टोग्राफिक हैश. विल सी व्हाट अ हैश इज. नहीं, इट इज पुट इन द डेटा एंड देन हैश इज कैलकुलेटेड, ठीक है. ये अभी हम देख लेते हैं. सो अ ब्लॉक हैज डेटा, अ ब्लॉक हैज इट्स ओन हैश, एंड अ ब्लॉक हैज हैश ऑफ द प्रीवियस ब्लॉक, ठीक है. So this is how you basically compute a hash of the data and of the previous. So this is what a block consists of. A block consists of these three things. Okay. So then he talks about transaction. This is right coming from his paper, and we will cover this. What is meant by owners, ones, public key? What is meant by owners, zeros, signature? Okay. What is meant by verification? What is meant by signing? So we are going to learn all these terminologies in order to understand the blockchain. Okay. So one by one, we will cover all these topics. Ji. First block has no previous blocks. ठीक है. So hash उसमें zero डाला है उन्होंने सारा. प्रीवियस ब्लॉक का हैश जीरो किया हुआ है, ठीक है. मैं आपको भी दिखाता भी हूँ इसको. जी जी आप बिल्कुल कर सकते हैं. आप अपना ब्लॉक से मुराद ये है कि आप एक ब्लॉक नया क्रिएट कर सकते हैं, ठीक. एनी बॉडी कैन क्रिएट एनी ब्लॉक. नहीं, अगले ब्लॉक नहीं करने पड़ेंगे. यू कैन, एवरी बॉडी इज ट्राइंग टू क्रिएट अ ब्लॉक, विल सी इन अ वाइल, ठीक है. अभी हम देखते हैं इसको. So you know, a transaction is where, what is a transaction? Where Alice is sending some money to Bob is a transaction. So these many bitcoins go from this person is a transaction. So all the transactions that happens in last 10 minutes are clumped together and are part of a block. Okay? And hash is like a fingerprint. It basically gives an identity, a unique identity to a block. So every block has a hash, which is a unique identity. Okay? So it has hash of the previous block. So this is, you know, just very broad concept that you have, this is the first block. Okay, so first block has the previous hash is 0000. That tells this is the first block in the blockchain. And then address of this hash, you put not the address, but you put this hash. It is not a pointer in programming language. So you put 1z8f whatever it is hash here, and then you have this hash you put here. So they are connected like this. Sorry. So this is an actual, the website I told you, which shows you all the blocks which are being generated. So this is blockchain.com, and this is a hash. This is the block number. 70, 30, 50 is the block number. 49, 50, 48, 49, 50. And you see a hash. It's a big number, so you only see part of it. And then you see the time. It is mined. Okay, it is 1 minute. And who is the miner? So sometimes miners, they have an identity, sometimes they don't want to even reveal their identity. So you will find unknown, unknown, unknown. This is size of the block. Okay. So if I get into this, you see more details. So if you see this, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. So 11 zeros, Bitcoin forces the miner. Sorry, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19. 19 zeros. So the algorithm forces the miners to come up with a hash. And this is also your assignment. I will give you a program where you can compute a hash. And then you will try to bring 3 zeros in front. Manually you have to put a number. And that number is called, I'll show you the noise in a while. But last time we also covered this, that this is the block. So this guy came up with this and he got in reward 6.25 Bitcoin. We saw it last time, that 6.25 Bitcoins are awarded to this miner who could mine this successfully. So everybody try. And whosoever finds this hash, okay, he says, I have actually found the hash. And he basically sent this to everybody in the network that I have this hash. जी इसमें कुछ भी नहीं है जी, माइनिंग में कोई एक्सपर्ट ही नहीं चाहिए. आज मैं आपको सिखा दूंगा, यू कैन माइन, यू कैन गो होम एंड माइन योर सेल्फ. अगर कोई थोड़ा बहुत किसी को प्रोग्रामिंग आती है, यू कैन राइट अ प्रोग्राम एंड माइन द ब्लॉक.
सर इस ब्लॉक में जैसे 3187 ट्रांजैक्शन
या
हमें ब्लॉक के थ्रू कितनी मात्रा से हमने ट्रांसफर कर दिया, हम ब्लॉक के
नहीं, वो कह रहे हैं ब्लॉक की क्या जरूरत है. देखें ब्लॉक की इसलिए जरूरत है कि अदरवाइज यू गॉट टू वैलिडेट, अनलेस योर ट्रांजेक्शन इन अ ब्लॉक. सो यू हैव अ वे ऑफ नोइंग वेदर माई ट्रांजेक्शन इज अ वैलिड, वेदर इट इज बींग एक्सेप्टेड बाई द ब्लॉक चेन नेटवर्क और नॉट. अब वो किस तरह से देखें, वो भी बड़ा कॉम्प्लेक्स प्रोसेस है. हाउ डू यू फाइंड, आपने एक ट्रांजेक्शन किया, जरूरी नहीं है वो ब्लॉक चेन में आए. ओके, एंड यू हैव टू कीप सम मनी फॉर द माइनर. So if you look at this, he says this is the money which he got for as a reward. Then there is a little money with an additional this much money reward paid as a fee for 3187 blocks. This is the money that you have to keep. Once you make a transaction, you need to leave a little money as a fee. If you don't leave any money, people will remove your transaction from the block. Okay, and you may have to wait 6 months for your transaction to be part of a block. जी ये 6.25 हैं सिर्फ, यही जनरेट होते हैं, यही रिवॉर्ड है उसका. ठीक है जी, अगर एक से ज्यादा बंदों के बाद आता है तो फिर क्या होता है कि एक फोर्क बन जाता है ब्लॉकचेन में, एंड देन इट फाइंड्स आउट द लॉन्गेस्ट. सो पीपल वंस यू हैव अ ट्रांजेक्शन, यू स्टिल हैव टू वेट फॉर 5 additional transactions to happen, and then you say which has the longest chain. वो दूसरा खुद ही खत्म हो जाता है. Okay, so it is decentralized, it is happening automatically, and they have all these measures in place to ensure that if a fork is generated, it'll die automatically, and there will only be just one chain, which is the longest chain that survive. बिकॉज देखिए सारा डिसेंट्रलाइज है, कोई सेंट्रल अथॉरिटी होना वो ये कह सकती है ओके दिस इज द फी यू हैव टू पे फॉर दिस, सो यू हैव टू जस्ट लीव अ लिटल फी. नेटवर्क्स हैं वो खुद कहेंगे हमारी इतनी है, हमारी इतनी है, बट बिकॉज ऑफ द डिसेंट्रलाइजेशन नथिंग इज कंट्रोल्ड बाय अ सेंट्रल अथॉरिटी विच सेज के इतनी फीस होगी. जी दिस इज वाइट. जी 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 वो मैं आप जी इसमें इन्होंने मैं आपको दिखाता हूँ इसका प्रीवियस हैश जो है ना, यहाँ पे नहीं है बट हेयर इज द प्रीवियस हैश. ओके, सो दैट्स व्हाई दे हैव नॉट शोन इट, यू कैन गेट इट. दिस इज द हैश ऑफ द प्रीवियस ब्लॉक, दिस इज द करंट ब्लॉक. इसके अंदर इसका हैश शामिल होगा, इसके अंदर इसका हैश शामिल होगा. सही है, सो यू हैव हैश. देर इज ऑल्सो देर इज अनदर हैश. ओके, देर इज अनदर हैश विच इज कॉल्ड, अभी हम देखेंगे जो मर्कल ट्री बनता है उसके रूट का हैश, सो दैट यू कैन फाइंड योर ट्रांजेक्शन इन द ब्लॉक और नॉट. सो दिस इज द मैकेनिज्म. अब क्या होता है कि लेट्स से देर इज एन इंट्रूडर एंड हु वॉन्ट्स टू कम, एंड इंस्टेड ऑफ मी सेंडिंग समथिंग टू समबडी एंड ही चेंजेज इट सो दैट द मनी गोज समवेयर एल्स. सो ही सेज नहीं ये ट्रांजेक्शन ऐसे नहीं है, ये ऐसे है. सो इफ ही चेंजेस दैट तो द हैश विल चेंज. और अब अगले ब्लॉक बनना शुरू हो गए हैं. ओके सो इफ ही चेंजेस दिस, ये जो ब्लॉक है ये इनवैलिड हो जाएगा. द नेक्स्ट ब्लॉक विल बी इनवैलिड एंड ऑल दी सब्सिक्वेंट ब्लॉक्स जो हैं वो इनवैलिड हो जाएंगे. और वो जो कॉन्सेंसस का एल्गोरिथम है वो इसको निकाल के बाहर फेंक दे. इट विल नॉट कंसिडर दिस ब्लॉक एज अ वैलिड ब्लॉक बिकॉज दे गॉट टू कन्फर्म के ब्लॉक इज क्रिएटेड इज लिंक्ड विद द प्रीवियस ब्लॉक्स और नॉट. उनकी उनसे लिंक होता है कि नहीं होता. सो ये आपका यहाँ पर आपको आइडेंटिफाई हो जाएगा और इसको निकाल के लोग फेंक देंगे. सो इन अ ब्लॉक चेन द ब्लॉक्स आर क्रिएटेड, दे आर चेन टूगेदर विद द हैश ऑफ द प्रीवियस ब्लॉक इंक्लूडेड वाइल यू कंप्यूट द हैश ऑफ द करंट ब्लॉक. ओके एंड देन टू मेक श्योर दैट नॉट पीपल आर नॉट जस्ट जनरेटिंग, एज यू सेड दे आर नॉट जस्ट जनरेटिंग ब्लॉक्स या वैसे ही उसकी ट्रांजेक्शन को चेंज नहीं कर रहे हैं. ही कैप्ट समथिंग विच इज कॉल्ड अ प्रूफ ऑफ वर्क. दैट वट इज अ प्रूफ ऑफ वर्क, प्रूफ ऑफ वर्क इज that the this distributed algorithm Satoshi made it so complex, so intensive, compute intensive, that you cannot generate a block in less than 10 minutes. It will take the no matter how much CPU power you put in, almost 10 minutes. Then there is a mechanism, if people are doing it earlier than this, it will increase the difficulty. The algorithm by itself will increase the difficulty if it finds out that people are basically mining the blocks faster than the 10 minutes, average 10 minutes. So, uske andar ye inbuilt rakha hua hai ki you cannot, on average, it should take, so they compute average after let's say 2 weeks and they say we need to increase the complexity or we need to decrease the complexity so that average time in generating a block is 10 minutes. Hum abhi thodi si break karte hain thodi der mein, bas isko main dekh lu. So it's a peer to peer network, so we understand the proof of work is everybody can mine. So ab ye sare log hain, if they want to mine they can mine, and if only there are few people, so there is no restriction who mines the block. Okay, so even I know for sure in Pakistan there are many people who are doing the mining, because mining is very simple. कोई साइंस नहीं है बहुत बड़ी उसमें से. तो माइनिंग इज सिंपल, ऑल यू हैव टू डू इज जस्ट कंप्यूट अ हैश. ओके सो यू कंप्यूट अ हैश एंड एनीबडी हु कम्स अप विद इट एंड ही सेज ओके आई हैव दिस न्यू ब्लॉक. जी जीपीयूज भी हैं, एसिक्स भी हैं, डिपेंड्स. हो सकता है आप अपने कंप्यूटर पे भी कर सकते हैं. पुलिंग हो रही है आजकल. Like you have compute power and you say I can give this compute power, so they'll download a program and they'll use your computer to primarily mine a new block, and they give you part of the reward money, a little they make, so you get also part of the money. And I have a proposal from somebody who wants to put a mining in KPK. So this is, we have surplus hydro power that we can use to mine. So mining is ji कार से करने लगा है. बट यू कैन बेसिकली, हमारे तो पावर का बहुत ज्यादा मसला है. सो लुक, सो दिस इज एवरीबडी इन अ ब्लॉक चेन हैज कॉपी ऑफ ऑल द ब्लॉक्स. एक बिकॉज इट्स अ डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड नेटवर्क, सो एवरी वन हैज अ कॉपी ऑफ ऑल द ब्लॉक्स एंड एवरीथिंग. सो वंस अ न्यू ब्लॉक इज जनरेटेड इट इज सेंड टू एवरीबडी. अच्छा, ब्लॉक generation is very difficult. It takes a miner 10 minutes to create a block, but checking whether this is a valid block or not is very simple. Okay, it is very simple. You can just check whether this is a valid block or not. So that is what he, this is a very key idea in blockchain, that generating a block is very difficult, but verifying whether it is a it's a valid block or not is very simple. So kya hota hai, a new block is formed, it is sent to everybody. ठीक है, एवरीबडी चेक्स, एवरीबडी इन द नेटवर्क इट चेक्स वेदर इट्स अ वैलिड 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 वैलिड. सो देर इज अ कॉन्सेंसस एल्गोरिथम. इफ मोर देन 50% पीपल सेज इट इज अ वैलिड ब्लॉक, ओनली देन इट इज एडेड इन द ब्लॉकचेन. ओके सो दिस इज द कॉन्सेंसस एल्गोरिथम. सो वी विल लर्न अबाउट हाउ द कॉन्सेंसस एल्गोरिथम वर्क्स, एंड इफ देर इज अ कॉन्सेंसस एंड देन अ ब्लॉक इज एडेड इन द ब्लॉकचेन. ओके सो दिस इज द गाय So nobody knows about Satoshi Nakamoto. Nobody knows about him. But this is the guy who started Ethereum. He's the coder, and he was only 19 years old, a Canadian. Okay? And his name is Vitalik, and he is the founder and inventor of Ethereum, which is precisely a same thing as blockchain, but more flexible. He thought about not only currency, he thought about value. He said, why we should confine it to just cryptocurrency, okay? He said, anything which is valuable is moving in the network, the blockchain should support it, number one. And then he came up with this idea of smart contract, okay? Which is auto-executable contracts, which runs in the code. I gave you example of these contracts last time, like you are renting a house, and if somebody does not pay, so the banks are connected in the blockchain, and they by themselves figure out whether rent is being paid by 5th of the month or not. If not, they'll just lock out the door. Okay? So these are self-executing contracts. So he made provision of adding a self-executing contract in Ethereum. Okay? So he expanded this whole concept of blockchain in ensuring that you can do a lot more than what is being done. इसका एल्गोरिथम बहुत डिफरेंट है ठीक है हाँ ये टू इसके एल्गोरिथम में यू कैन राइट अ स्मार्ट कॉन्ट्रैक्ट ठीक है एंड स्मार्ट कॉन्ट्रैक्ट यूजली इज इन मैनी इफ एल्स स्टेटमेंट इफ दिस हैपन्स डू दिस एल्स डू दिस एल्स डू दिस ओके सो ही टॉक्ड अबाउट लाइक द इंफॉर्मेशन एज आई वॉज मैंशनिंग अर्लियर देयर इज एन इंफॉर्मेशन यू वॉन्ट कॉपीज टू बी मेड ओके पावर पॉइंट स्लाइड्स हैं वेबसाइट्स हैं PDF files and you want copies to be made. But then there are informations where these are the digital assets. You talked about digital assets where that asset has a value and you can trade that asset using smart contract and using blockchain technology. So they may be identities, social capital, energy, art, votes, financial assets, contracts. So he expanded the blockchain to get into so many domains. Okay, so that is, and then came the IBM. We'll study about the IBM as well. So this is for the permissionless blockchain. A permissionless blockchain is where it is open to public. Anybody can be part of the blockchain. So this is open to public. So anything where just general public want to trade things, so you can use Ethereum as a platform. But if you have an organization, your office, and where you want to use blockchain in your organization, then you use a permissioned blockchain, and there is a different platform for that, which is. So this is the central to blockchain is a smart contract. Okay, again, smart contract is a self-executing contract. It is a piece of code, and the contracts will. For sure, the contracts, because it gives you justice right away. You don't have to go to the lawyers and the courts. Everything is built into the contract, and people would love it because they won't. Because whenever you have an asset, you always have a trust deficit. Like makan kisi ko kiraye pe dena hai, you are always worried that whether you will able to get him out of the house or not if he does not pay rent. So almost all, that's why people are very interested in this, because they believe that this will serve justice. And then perhaps at some point lawyers need to understand the programming language, because a contract will be written in a programming language. ठीक है जिसमें मैं आपको वो Gartner का hype cycle भी दिखा रहा था. So this is where the contracts will be written in a programming language. You got to make sure that it is complete in all aspect, and then you make the contract to execute. So no human base, it will be from sensors, IoTs, okay? So the input will come from IoTs, and even if there is an human input is required, so you can add that, it does not matter. But contract will be a self-executing contract. It will execute automatically. And obviously, once you want a contract to execute automatically, okay, usme aapko, you have to link so many things together. So we will, so then he finds so many different applications. That's why people say blockchain is applicable to almost anything you think. And slowly, this is what is happening, that this aspect of blockchain, leaving the Bitcoin aside, this is the aspect of the blockchain that is getting more attraction. And people are now thinking of developing, I mentioned smart cities with smart contracts, with the transfer happens in a blockchain network, the land transfers and, you know, so everything. So blockchain, that's why, is gaining more and more popularity, that you have so many different use cases and application. And I'll show you the, there are many companies. In Utah, they tried blockchain in last presidential election. They have several presidential elections. So then your mobile phone becomes your identity wallet. And no matter where you are, you can actually cast your vote on a blockchain network. Okay, we will study these, and there are many companies, many startups, many companies which are heavily investing in this area. And you can always come up with an idea, and that's what I kept as an objective of this course, that if you think in those terms, you may come up with interesting ideas, keeping in perspective Pakistan, that yes, this is where you can apply the blockchain. And that will be part of the project as well that you will do, that you take a use case and build a blockchain solution around that. And always remember that blockchain hates this middle person, this central authority. So it basically a distributed technology where decisions are happening in a distributed way, that there is no central authority where you have to go and register yourself or get permission or you will not able to create because it's so difficult, it is so random. I'll send you a transaction, a set of transactions, and I'll ask you to generate a block out of that where there should be three leading zeros. One leading zeros means there are, if you try, there are 2^4, 16 possible attempts, aapko zero mil jayega. Agar ek zero hai na, aap char dafa koshish karenge, so there is the probability that you may get, even it's possible ke zero pe hi aa jaye aapka, ya pehla zero jo hai, dusre pe aaye, teesre pe aaye, chauthe, panchve, chhate, aa jayega. But if I say bring two zeros, so 2^8, 64 aapko attempts karni padenge. The worst case is maybe even more, because baad ukaad ek jo digit hai wo bar bar aa raha hoga. Then if it is 3, so it is 2^12, okay? So you have to make 2^12 attempts. Or just 2^16 is a big number, not 16 into 4, 2^64, which runs into it's a big number. That so aap har ek block banega nahi aapka aur random hoga, theek hai? Jab main abhi assignment dunga, anybody who sends the that number will get the actual reward. So usko next class mein hum reward denge, which will be a reward. Okay, we'll see who comes up with a new block. So hum ye try karke dekhenge, so that you get that what is proof of work. Hum abhi bas isko break karte hain. Let's finish this 2-3 slides. Phir taake hum zara fresh aake hum 20 minute ki break karenge. So new block is created, is fine. So we understand the proof of work. This is the Bitcoin. Ye main sirf aapko ye maine pehle dikhaya hua hai. So I've shown you this as well, but this is something which I wanted to show you. Noise. This is a number. Okay? Noise. This is a number which is in your control. You put this number, so without this, you have the transaction and hash of the previous block and timestamp. Uska to hash ek hi aayega. You compute a hash, there is a number. But in order to bring all the zeros, theek hai, ye aapka control hai. You try just different numbers here, 0, 1, 2. It's up to you whether you want to try random numbers. and you want to run in a sequence 0 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10 11 12, just keep trying. Every time you change this number, the hash will change, and you just keep trying until you hit all those leading zeros. And once you hit that, you say, bingo, I got the solution. So you share this, you say this is the noise, so anybody can check. Wo sare transactions ko aapki dalega, pichle ka hash dalega, ye magic number dalega usme. This is the magic number, which is 1118 1917, and it says yes, you got the answer. Yes, you got the answer. Once we do the exercise, and whosoever comes up with number, everybody would able to just check whether this is the correct answer or not. And you say yes, this is the correct answer, this is the correct answer, and you start saying yes, he got the correct answer. So it means a valid block is generated. Ye wo hai, this is amazing how he came up with this idea. This is the difficulty level. If he finds out it is getting too difficult, it will decrease the level of difficulty to make sure that a new block is generated every 10 minutes. So it is just playing with the difficulty level. सही है, उसने कहा ये जल्दी जल्दी बन रहे हैं तो इसको डिफिकल्टी ज़्यादा करता गया, ज़्यादा करता गया यहाँ पर. उसने कहा नहीं, ये ज़्यादा डिफिकल्ट हो गया. ओके, सो ही इज़ ड्रॉपिंग द डिफिकल्टी. देन ही सेइंग नो, डिफिकल्टी जो है कम हो गई है, सो ही इज़ इंक्रीजिंग द डिफिकल्टी. सो दिस ये एल्गोरिथम इटसेल्फ कर रहा है, ठीक है. ये जीरोज ऐड करने से डिफिकल्टी पर नीचे हो जाती है, ठीक है. एंड देन हाउ मेनी पावर पीपल आर पुटिंग इन, उसे लोगों ने बड़ी पावर डालना शुरू कर दिया, अभी देखता हूँ मैं. सो इंक्रीज द डिफिकल्टी, सही है. सो दिस इज हाउ द एल्गोरिथम इज एडजस्टिंग इटसेल्फ, मेकिंग श्योर दैट लाइक द फिएट करेंसी विद द गवर्नमेंट से जनरेट, एंड यू से जस्ट अ की ऑन अ कंप्यूटर से जनरेट हो गए. यू कैन नॉट जनरेट Bitcoin in a similar fashion. You 6.25 Bitcoin से ज़्यादा average में generate नहीं हो सकते. Algorithm इसको make sure कर रहा है, and this is the proof of work. ठीक है, this is the beauty of the algorithm, of the whole system, that no matter how much power you put in, it'll make sure that you will not able. और फिर आपको खुद हो गया कि यार मैं energy ज़्यादा लगा रहा हूँ, पैसा मुझे कम मिल रहा है, so you don't want to be in loss, so you will start decreasing the amount of CPU power you are putting in to generate 6.25 Bitcoin. ब्लॉक बनने खत्म हो जाएंगे, सिर्फ नहीं, फिर सिर्फ, हाँ जी, फिर आपको वो नहीं मिलेंगे, आपके सिर्फ ट्रांजेक्शन हो रही होंगे. फिर जी ट्रांजेक्शन हो रही होंगी, ट्रांजेक्शन फी चार्ज हो रही होगी फिर, ठीक है. पीपल विल बी चार्ज विद द ट्रांजेक्शन फी. जी जी हैश, जी ये प्रूफ ऑफ वर्क इज कमिंग फ्रॉम दी हैश. ये शार 256 है जिससे हैश निकालते हैं, वो एल्गोरिथम अभी हम देखते हैं, ठीक है. विल सी दी एल्गोरिथम टुडे, एंड वी नॉट ओनली दैट, वो बहुत सादा सा एल्गोरिथम है. आप मसलन उसमें कोई वो साइंस नहीं है. सो दिस इज वेयर वी टेक ब्रेक. वंस वी कम बैक इन 20 मिनट्स, सो वी गो एंड लर्न अबाउट क्रिप्टोग्राफिक हैश फंक्शन, सही है. एंड दिस इज द सेंट्रल टू ब्लॉकचेन टेक्नोलॉजी. यू विल सी दैट हाउ हैशेस आर कंप्यूटेड, द असाइनमेंट, एंड देन वी विल स्टार्ट द क्रिप्टोग्राफिक हैश फंक्शन. सो एज आई मेंशन अर्लियर, आई विल गिव यू अ वेब एड्रेस ऑफ this utility which can compute the hash. Okay, so it computes the hash of whatever transactions or whatever data you put in. I have put here like these four transactions where Ahmed is sending some money to Jawad, and Ahmed is sending some money to somebody else, and there are four people who are sending money, and you see in the bottom there is a hash. अच्छा एक मिनट, जी जी मैं एक मिनट कर रहा हूँ, आपको शेयर, एंड सो आई नीड टू शेयर दी द स्क्रीन. and for the students I need to share the screen too. So now you see this, right? So this is a utility and the website. You just go on this website. This is where I will give you this a set of transaction. I'll give you that, and there is a hash of it here. अब यहाँ पे नॉइस डालेंगे आप, ठीक है? A number you will put by yourself. Let's say I put a zero, and you will see the hash will change. You see, the hash will change. So then you put and you have to bring three leading zeros here. यहाँ पे you got to bring three leading zeros by trying different noise in this, and anybody who finds the first, ठीक है, he needs to put it on the group. कि जी ये मैंने ढूंढ लिया है, दिस इज द नॉइस. सो द अदर पीपल कैन एक्चुअली चेक, एंड हू एवर फाइंड्स द फर्स्ट विल गेट अ रिवॉर्ड, सो अ कैश रिवॉर्ड. सो 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, and you can try different numbers, random number, 21, 22. Just I got 10. Okay, by in 22 tries I could only get 10, and you have to find three leading zeros by hit and trial. Okay, so this is the proof of work, that these are the transactions. By finding this magic number, yesterday I tried, I could, like, in my fifth attempt I got 2 zeros. You know, sometimes because it is random, you may get, ideally I should have gotten it in 16 attempts, but it has taken me 22 attempts to get this number. So it depends. इसी तरह अगर मैं 4 कर दूंगा तो it will become even more difficult. Manually it will become more difficult. Maybe if, जी हाँ, ये शुरू के लीडिंग जीरोस की लिमिट है. ये जो लीडिंग जीरो शुरू के है ना, इसमें थ्री लीडिंग जीरोस होने चाहिए. आप जो मर्जी लिख दें, आप जो मर्जी लिख दें, सही है, आप ट्राई मारते जाएं. सो इट्स अप टू यू. सो यू कैन जस्ट पुट एनी नंबर, मैनेजेबल होना चाहिए, ठीक है? सो बट यू कैन पुट एनी नंबर. But look at this beauty, that this number is always the length of the hash is always fixed. ठीक है? And you make a slight change in this. Let's say you only put a dot here. This number will completely change. ठीक है? You only put a little thing, very little variation. If you try to play with this number only by putting a dot, will change the hash. Okay, so that's the reason that you cannot make any changes in the ledger, because if you do that, the hash will change and it'll completely change. Otherwise you may not able to find out the change here, but this number will change totally. This number will change. So hash is an amazing यूटिलिटी. नॉन्स इधर ऊपर यहाँ पे आप डालेंगे. नहीं, अब आपने व्हाट्सएप के ग्रुप पे शेयर करना है. जो सबसे पहले व्हाट्सएप के ग्रुप पे डालेगा, ही विल गेट द रिवॉर्ड. जी नहीं, इसी वे ताकि एवरीबॉडी शुड सी. एडमिन कैन ओनली पोस्ट, देन इस पर कर लेते हैं टीम्स पे. नहीं नहीं, मुझे नहीं, बिकॉज एवरीबडी हैज़ टू सी. लेट्स यार ये इसकी वो चेंज कर दें, एवरीबडी कैन पोस्ट ऑन द ग्रुप. सो विल से एवरीबडी. जी जी बताएं.
ये ऑनलाइन टूल जो आप यूज कर रहे हैं, इसका लिंक सेंड करें.
जी, इसका लिंक मैं सेंड करूंगा आपको, ठीक है? आई विल सेंड यू द लिंक ऑफ दिस. सो दैट इज द प्रूफ ऑफ वर्क, कि यू हैव टू ट्राई डिफरेंट नंबर्स. लेट मी रिपीट दिस, कि ये एक यूटिलिटी है SHA-256 की, विच कंप्यूट्स अ हैश. सो दिस इज प्रिसाइजली व्हाट द ब्लॉकचेन यूजेस, अ हैश 256. जी, 3 leading zeros. Yes. वो भी गया. Yes. Yes, you can get consecutive zeros, but I don't know how many hit and trial. So, but the good thing about this is, for example, now you know that if I put 22, I'll get a zero. जी या डॉट की वजह इफ आई रिमूव द डॉट या ओके सो एवरीबॉडी विल इंस्टेंटली एबल टू चेक वेदर द पर्सन हु हैज पोस्टेड इज राइट और नॉट सो दीज आर द टू थिंग्स विच आई वांट टू डू रिवॉर्ड अच्छा रिवॉर्ड होगा सही है कुछ नहीं नथिंग इज डिफाइंड Neither it is defined that how many tries you have to do to get these zeros. ठीक है As now you got a 1-0, you may say, अच्छा एक तो आ गया अब दूसरा करते हैं No, no, no. If you change this number to, let's say, 22, and you say, oh, वो भी गया ठीक है वो एक जीरो आया था वो भी गया दोबारा से ठीक है So it means that bringing 3 consecutive leading zeros is not an easy job. Okay? And if I say 4, सो हो सकता है कि आप अगले दिन 4 या 5 तो हो सकता है आप आए कि या क्या आपने असाइनमेंट दिया ये एल्गोरिथम ये एल्गोरिथम डिफाइन करता है अगर लेट से क्लास मतलब मैंने देखा कि यार ये तो 5 मिनट में लोगों ने कर दिया अगली दफ़ा मैं कहूँगा नहीं 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 ना 5 लीडिंग जीरोस यू नो नाउ डेफिनेटली दैट इज गोइंग टू टेक मोर टाइम सो एल्गोरिथम विल डिसाइड दैट हाउ क्विकली पीपल आर फिगरिंग दिस आउट मतलब आप पुलिंग कर सकते हैं आप कहें आपस में कि अच्छा 1 से 100 मैं ट्राई करता हूँ ठीक है 100 से 200 तुम ट्राई करो 200 से 300 सो यू मेक अ ग्रुप एंड यू डिवाइड यू के सारे ट्राई हम मारते हैं तो हम रिवॉर्ड शेयर कर लेंगे अगर रिवॉर्ड मिला तो हम 5 बंदे हैं तो हम रेंज रख लेते हैं कि 0 से 100 इट इज़ आई एम डूइंग इट 100 से 200 आप करो इससे ये करो इससे ये करो जो रिवॉर्ड मिला हम 5 बंदे आपस में डिवाइड कर लेंगे then you have better winning of you have better probability to win because now 5 people are trying and they have different ranges in which they are trying theek hai so similarly you say let's say the entire class says ki hum sare milke karte hain and you divide that this is I will try this you try but anybody who finds you are going to share the reward equally with the others so this is what people are doing this is pooling that they pool the resources And with this promise that depending upon the compute power, let's say कोई कहता है मैं 1 घंटा लगाऊंगा इसको करने में कोई कहता है मैं अच्छा मैं 2 घंटे लगाऊंगा कोई कहता है मैं 3 घंटे लगाऊंगा सो यू से बेस्ड ऑन द एफर्ट वी विल स्प्रेड द रिवॉर्ड समबडी हू इज सेइंग 1 आवर विल गेट ओनली 1 पार्ट ऑफ दिस सो यू कंप्यूट रेशो सो इन पुलिंग दे से दैट हाउ मच कंप्यूट पावर समबडी इज पुलिंग इन सो ही गेट्स अ रिवॉर्ड अकॉर्डिंग टू दैट सही जी Yes, if you are lucky, like it's a jackpot. आप कहें ये तो पहली दफ़ा ही आ गए सी बट इट इज़ हाईली अनलाइकली दैट यू विल गेट 3 लीडिंग जीरोज इन द फर्स्ट अटैम्प्ट वो भी गया यस जी जी पूछें जी जी मैं ये बता रहा हूँ कि ये एक वेबसाइट है जिसका मैंने आई हैव गिवन यू द एड्रेस This website computes the hash, precisely the hash which is used in blockchain Bitcoin, okay? Which is called SHA-256. We are going to learn about it. यहाँ पे मैंने खुद से ये transactions डाली हैं. I have copied a block of transactions, and this block of transaction has some hash, which you see in the window, in the second window at the bottom. ठीक है? हमने यहाँ पे डिफरेंट नंबर ट्राई करने हैं जो कि माइनर ट्राई करते हैं लाइक यू विल बिकम अ माइनर एंड यू ट्राई डिफरेंट नंबर्स टू गेट 3 लीडिंग जीरोस तो आप मैंने ट्राई करना शुरू किया था लेट्स से 0 सो आई गेट समथिंग आई गेट 2 नहीं मिला मुझे 3 नहीं मिला 4 सो वंस यू ट्राई यू विल ऑलवेज गेट अ डिफरेंट हैश सो हम ये ट्राई करते करते हमें 22 पे सॉरी 22 पे मुझे 22 पे मुझे 1 जीरो मिला था बट वंस आई डिड 23 आई इवन लॉस दैट अगेन सो बट आई हैव द सेकेंड जीरो यू सी. तो आपने इसको आई जस्ट वॉन्ट यू टू अंडरस्टैंड दैट वट माइनस डस एंड हाउ द प्रूफ ऑफ वर्क डस वर्क एंड आई वॉन्ट यू टू जी जी बताएं. जी जी आप कुछ भी लिखेंगे ना इवन एम्प्टी भी करेंगे इसका भी हैश होता है. सो इफ आई डिलीट एवरीथिंग इसका भी हैश है. ठीक है बट आई हैव नॉट गिवन. लेकिन आपने वो क्या लिखा हुआ है उसमें. वाह जी वाह वन से आ गए. नहीं ये नहीं ये किस तरह आया होगा तो नहीं हो सकता. अहमद चलो इन्हें देखो शी वॉज लकी शी गॉट. लेकिन ये वो असाइनमेंट वाली ट्रांजेक्शन नहीं है अभी. बट शी गॉट थ्री जीरोज इन हर फर्स्ट अटेम्प्ट बाय पुटिंग अ वन. सो यू सी सो दिस इज अ स्ट्रोक ऑफ लक कि हमने जी यानी कि इफ दे आर इक्वल प्रोबेबल देन यू नीड 16 बट दे आर दीज आर नॉट इक्वल प्रोबेबल. अगर इक्वली प्रोबेबल होता ना कि जो फर्स्ट लेटर है वो जीरो की प्रोबेबिलिटी आना वन की टू की थ्री की तो वर्स्ट केस में आपको 16 चाहिए होते. बट बिकॉज इट्स नॉट इक्वल प्रोबेबल सो दैट्स व्हाई यू डोंट नो. जीरो से इन्फिनिटी तक हो सकता है. ठीक है नॉइस दिस इज द नॉइस. ठीक है नहीं 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 लेट्स डू दिस नाउ. इधर भी आ रहा है. सो लेट्स नाउ अंडरस्टैंड दैट हाउ द हैश इज कंप्यूटेड. ओके सो वी सी हैश एंड हैशेज आर ऑल्सो आप देखेंगे द एवरी ट्रांजेक्शन इज ऑल्सो हैश्ड. देन दे क्लम द ट्रांजेक्शन टुगेदर दे अगेन क्रिएट अ हैश. सो हैशेज आर कंप्यूटेड अ लॉट. सो दैट्स वाई हैश इज वेरी ये अनॉयंस है कि जो प्रीवियस ब्लॉक ये जो ब्लॉकचेन में ट्रांजेक्शन्स होती हैं वो सारी आप क्लम करते हैं और उनका हैश कंप्यूट करना होता है आपको. और उसमें आपने इसको बिटकॉइन दे दी उसने उसको दे दी उसको उसने दे दी. यू आर जस्ट इट इज़ अ ट्रांजेक्शन वेयर यू आर गिविंग बिटकॉइंस. वन पर्सन इज गिविंग बिटकॉइंस टू अनदर पर्सन. ठीक है अच्छा आप देखें ये जो हैश है ना दिस इज़ कॉल्ड अ सिक्योर शाह. वैसे तो लगता है शाहजी हैं कोई ना सब सब पीर साहब लेकिन इट इज़ फॉर सिक्योर हैश एल्गोरिथम. सो इट्स अ क्यूट नेम बट दिस इज़ फॉर अ सिक्योर हैश एल्गोरिथम एंड इट दे स्टार्टेड द इट वाज इंट्रोड्यूस्ड बाय नेशनल सिक्योरिटी एजेंसी यूएसए एंड इन 1993 इट वाज शाह जीरो. देन दे केम अप विद शाह वन एंड दे वर रीजंस दैट नाउ दे हैव दिस सेकेंड फैमिली शाह टू. And SHA-2 family has many. The Bitcoin uses SHA-256. Okay, so they are many. It uses SHA-256 algorithm. SHA-256 is SHA-2 family ka one of a secure cryptographic hash function. It is adopted by FIPS is also a standard in 2002, and it generates a 256 bits hash. एंड विथ 512 बिट मैसेज ब्लॉक. ये मैं आई एक्सप्लेन. ओरिजिनल मैसेज का साइज कुड बी एनी थिंग लाइक 2^64 इज़ अ बिग नंबर. सो यू कैन हैव इवन अ इंटायर बुक एंड यू कैन कंप्यूट हैश ऑफ एन इंटायर बुक और एन इंसाइक्लोपीडिया. सो यू कैन कंप्यूट हैश ऑफ जस्ट एम्प्टी स्पेस और यू कैन कंप्यूट हैश ऑफ एन इंटायर बुक. Hash size will always be the same, which is 256 bits. Okay? So hash primarily either it expands if total number of bits are less than 256 or it compresses everything usually into a unique number. So yeah, hash function is generally one way. Ye bahut important hai ke hash jo hai wo usually a one way function hai. What is meant by a one way function? वन वे फंक्शन से क्या मुराद है. सो वन वे फंक्शन मीन्स दैट सो वन वे फंक्शन मीन्स दैट you can only go in one direction. For example, you are computing a hash. If I give you a hash, you cannot bring the data which generated that hash. Okay? One-way function का मतलब ये होता है कि you cannot go back. Let's say there is a hash. I say, tell me what is the number, which hash is this. There is absolutely no way for you. Almost. It is because the size could be anything. It is like a one-way function. A very simple example of one-way function is something adds up to 10. Okay, something adds up to 10 is a one-way function. There are infinite many possibilities to get 10, even if you are adding two numbers. Simple. It is 1 plus 9 is 10, 2 plus 8 is 10, chalte jaye, minus 1 plus 11 is 10. So there are infinite many ways to get. If I only tell you that I have added two numbers, the answer is 10, it is a one-way function. And if I ask you what are the two numbers, there could be infinite many possibilities, so you cannot figure that out. Okay? But if I give you the number and also tell you 10, then it'll take you in a matter of seconds and milliseconds and nanoseconds, and you will say yes, these are the two numbers. So this is called a one-way function. But addition is not a good one-way function. And there are several reasons, because one of the characteristic of this hash is that there are no two such numbers. There are only these unique input that will create this hash. Okay, so no two different inputs will create the same hash. In case of 10, there are infinite many numbers which will again create this number 10. So we will see that what are the characteristics of the hash function. So, ji? Ji, yani ke wo jo probability hai, wo 2 raised to the power 256 hai. Okay? 2 raised to the power 2, which is very, very, very low probability. Achha, ab dekhiye, whether it is a letter A. Ji, ji, please. Yeah, yeah. Yes. 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 Every time you put 23, you will get the same answer. So this is good, because everybody has to do a validation of your answer. So the entire network, once you announce, like in the class, once you come up with three zeros, everybody would able to check whether you have a correct answer or not. Okay. So no matter what is the size of the input, it always generates 256 bit number, which is represented as a hexadecimal number. And the size is 2 raised to the power 64 bits, so which is 10 raised to the power perhaps 18 words. It's a humongous amount of data that it allows you to have. This is the size of different hashes, hash algorithm, that input could be that big. Ye maximum limit hai, ji. इससे बड़ा डाटा ये नहीं लेगा एल्गोरिथम. उसके लिए फिर आपको हैश 512 पे जाना पड़ेगा. जी वो मैं कब बताने लगा हूँ अभी. आई टेल यू दैट. जी जी Yes. नहीं नहीं देखिए जो जो चेंज कर रहा है वो नॉइस है विच यू हैव टू पुट. डेटा सेट विल ऑलवेज जनरेट वन.